Hello everybody, I'm Pascal Serrarens from Paso VR, and today I'm going to show you a different application of InstantVR. We're not going to walk around this time, but we take the car. As you can see, I have a nice car. I'm using Unity Free Edition this time because we're from version 1.1 onward. You can use Free in combination with the Oculus Rift, so that's a nice opportunity to show this to you too. So we're going to take our car, which is actually a car which you can download from my site, and it includes steering and gas and braking, but it doesn't feature an avatar yet. So that is what we're going to do in this video. So we're going to add the standard InstantVR Advanced. In this case, we take the standard Make Human avatar, as we know it all, and we're going to place it in the car and try to drive it, use the steering wheel and gas and brake pedals. So I placed it in the scenery already, however, it's not on the right place. So we take the car and we see all kinds of sub-objects, including the seat. And that's where we're going to place our avatar. So we take the InstantVR reduced avatar and place it into the seat. So let's start by placing it at the zero position. And then we are going to place it roughly at the right place. So we should move down. Going to correct the legs later on. Down a bit backward, I see. Well, I think this is a good starting point, but we need to move the legs first. So I'm going to show you different ways of placing your avatar. The most straightforward one is just by changing the avatar itself to start with. So we go into the bone structure from the spine. Oh no, not the spine. It's the hips. We have the hips here. And we're just going to rotate the hips such that the legs are forward. And then we see, well, he's still a bit high in the car. So we move it a bit down. Is it correct? Oh, looks quite nice. Just rotate them up a bit. And then we move the lower legs a bit down. Have a bit more natural curvature. It looks okay. So now we have the avatar at the right place, but we're going to use the targets to move the body around, and those are still at the original place. So what we are going to do now is place the foot targets at the location where the foot of the avatar actually are. So we take the left foot, put it on the left foot of the avatar. We're losing the prefab, that's no problem because we're not going to use it anymore. So that's fine. And now we simply reset the position to 000, and you can see already it's roughly at the place where the foot is actually is. So that's fine now, and we put it back into the targets, and now we know that the foot target is in the right position. Next one is the right foot, in the same way, put it as a child, the foot itself. Reset all the positions to zero, so now the target is at the right position, and move it back into the target. Third one, which I'm going to do, is the head, because it's a bit too much up front. It's leaning to the front a bit, so now we're going to the spine because we're moving the upper part of the body and move it a bit. Oops, is it the right one? Not quite, I see. That's weird. Probably. Uh-oh. Ah! That's the one. somehow I took the wrong pivot. And that's also probably the reason why the hips are a bit strange looking now. Okay, but it's fine. A bit like this is okay. And just like before, now we have to replace the head movement, head target, because you can see it's a bit too much forward. Sorry. So we move the head target, which is actually at the neck of the avatar, and we set it to 0. Okay, so now we have quite a nice position. However, if we now start the thing, everything will flow away. Wah! Because actually car itself has a number of colliders, and you can also see that the avatar also has some colliders, and also it will create a number of colliders, and they all will bounce together. However, in this setup we're not going to use any colliders, so we have to change the number of settings in our avatar. So here we have the InstantVR reduced avatar. And we can see here in the input controller that walking is enabled. We don't need any walking, so we can disable this. This also will prevent a character controller being created, which is exactly what we want. Then we also have the hands, which we're actually not going to do much with it. We're not going to use a Razer Hydra or a game controller, so we just turn them off. So in the left-hand target, you can see now from version 1.1 onward, you can select the controls which are used. We're not going to use the Hydra or a mouse or a gamepad, and the same is true for the right hand. And the side effect of this is that also the colliders of the hands will be disabled. So now we have actually disabled all the colliders, and when we run the program, we should simply sit still. Okay, well, that's nice, but not much will be happening if I turn the wheel or do the gas. So how are we going to do that? What we're going to do is move the targets of the hands towards the steer. So make them a child of the steer. So when the steer is turning around, the targets will turn with them. So here we have the steering wheel of the Caterham, and we move the left-hand target and the right-hand target to the steering wheel. Of course, they are not at the steering wheel, so we have to adjust the positions. So to start with, we set it to 0 completely, so now it's in the middle of the steering wheel. Position should be, oops, a bit to the left, about 13 centimeters. I did this before, so I know the measurements about. So we want to angle it inward a bit, so 20 degrees inward. Something more. Yes, we also need to adjust the hand position. Normally the fingers will point in the forward direction. So now we see that the fingers are actually pointing downwards. That's not the thing we want. So in this way, they're actually pointing the right way. And then you also see that the thumb, that is the red arrow, the X arrow, is now pointing outward. So this needs to be upward in this case. So we also need to turn that up. And now we're almost done, because the only thing which we need to correct is that actually we're not positioning the palm of the hand, the middle of the hand, actually we're positioning the wrist. So we need to move the arrow about, what is it, 10 centimeters backwards. So now we're actually at the right position. So when we start, you see that the hand is it's a bit low, it can be a bit higher. So that's 12, yeah, that's okay. Can move it a bit higher, but I think it's okay. So that's the left hand. It can do the same for the right hand, so reset it to the middle of the steering wheel. And then do 13, what did I do? 13, 12, 13 centimeters, oops, not to the left, but to the right. Angle it inwards, but now the other way around. Move the forward position up and move the outward position. Oh, I was referring to a thumb, that's not a true axis. We are looking at the green arrow, the Y axis, which is actually the back of your hand pointing outward. So this is the back of your hand, this is the fingers. So, and okay, I need to move it 10 centimeters back. And if it's correct, see, now they are at the right position of the steering wheel. And when I turn the steering wheel, hey, this is looking better. So that's a different way of placing the position of your targets. It's the first method we did is just positioning the avatar itself and then align the targets with the positions of the neck or the hands or the feet. The other way is position the targets, and then your avatar will try to reach that those targets. So we have the steering wheel, so of course, let's see, I can turn the wheel, and of course, I can look around. So lots of movement happening, and it's all for free. Yeah, well, it's for free. When you use the Instant VR, everything will be working automatically. So the only thing which is not working yet is brake and throttle. You don't see the move the feet moving around pressing the buttons or pedals. So what we can do for that is add some scripting to do the pedal movement, because they're not actually not real pedals in the car, but you can simulate something like that. So we add a script, let's call it brake, because we're on the left foot here, and let's open the script editor. Okay, what we are going to use, when you look at the steering wheel, you can see here's the car control, which is actually not just moving the steering wheel, but also the accelerator and the brake pedals. So when you start the application, you can also see that acceleration and brake are entered over there. So we will use those values to move the feet around. So we go to our script, to the brake script, and we use the car controller as an input. Next to that is we need to store the starting position of the feet. So start position, because that will be our reference position. When you start, we store, oops, the initial position of the feet. So what we're now going to do in the update is adjust this position by using the brake pedal value of the car controller. So we take the transform position, the local position, and that position will be the start position, we have to look, so we have the left foot. Okay, you see the blue arrow, the four direction that's what we want to alter. So we will be moving the foot forward and backwards along the forward direction. So initially we move it well about 5 centimeters back, 5 degrees forward. So we're not using the input value, so let's see if this is resulting in this lag moving back. You see? Okay, it's also moving a bit upward because that's the only way we can move your feet back. So the inverse kinematics is already working for us. And now we need to add this value of the car controller, the brake pedal, and that will be a value between 0 and 1, and we want to adjust it to 0 and 5 centimeters, because then when we press the brake pedal completely, it will be in the starting position again. So this should do the job. Let's see. Okay, there we are. Pressing the brake. Oops. Not doing the... Oh, yeah. Of course. The car controller. We need to insert the car controller here. So now you can see the leg is moving upward, and when I press the brake, the leg is moving. Oh, it's nice, isn't it? Okay, steering wheel, brake pedal, looking around. It's also easy when things are done for you. Okay, so that's the left foot. Right foot, we do the same thing, but then accelerator. Different one. Actually, we are going to use almost the same script. Maybe we confuse them into one, but let's do it the easy way. Copy. Okay, so we copy the brake script into the accelerator script, and of course, instead of the brake pedal value, we're going to use the accelerator value. And if I'm not mistaken, then this will be doing the job. Okay, brake pedal. Nope. Same mistake as before. We need car controller public value filled in. See? Okay, so now the left move and the right move. And you can also see it in the cockpit. Braking and gas. Okay, so here we go. Driving around in our Caterham. Full on the throttle. Moving around. Looking cool. Being happy. So, I hope you enjoyed this instruction. I hope you are now convinced that InstantVR is not just about walking around, grabbing things, which is a lot of fun, of course, and it's most impressive. But you can use it in a completely different setup, without razor hydras, etc., without walking around, but using a steering wheel configuration and an Oculus Rift in this case, and do all kinds of things, move your body for free. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and goodbye to the next one. See you.